Fortunately, there is a better way. We are going to use a technology called templates. Templates generally refer to a library, as a template library is a library to build complicated strings. And by strings, I really mean any string. But when you're developing web applications, most of the time, we're referring to HTML, because those are the strings we generate the vast majority of the time. And in this lesson, and really for the rest of this class, I'm going to be using a template library called Jinja 2. The reason we're using this is because it's built into Google App Engine. And you know, there are many templating libraries, and they're all very, very similar. And Jinja 2, while this course is the first time I've been exposed to it, was very easy to learn for me because it is very similar to other template libraries that I've used. So it should be very similar to other template libraries that you will probably find yourself using down the road. You can find more information about Jinja at jinja.pocoo.org, P-O-C-O-O.org. Let's start integrating this into the little toy app we've been building and see how things look. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is update our app.yaml. This is an App Engine thing. If you want to include external libraries, you need to do this. You get a libraries line, you give the library name, and you say which version to use. You don't need to fully understand this right now, to be honest. I don't fully understand this right now. You can find more information in the App Engine docs if you want to start including more libraries. Next, what we do is we add an import statement to import Jinja. At this point, I'm going to reload our web app just to make sure this import statement worked, which basically implies that the app.yaml update worked as well. So I get to this page, and I hit reload, and it looks like it worked. If there was an error, you know, let's say I typed this incorrectly, you know, adding an extra 2, this is something you might see when you're doing this on your own, and I reload this page, you'll get, you know, you'll see blank or nothing, and then if I look at my terminal, we can see an error in my terminal, no module name Jinja 2.2. So if you see this, you know, make sure you updated your app.yaml properly and make sure you typed the module name properly. Okay, let's get rid of that. I'm going to add a couple lines to initialize Jinja. What these two lines are, basically, where you're using the OS library, which is built in the Python. os.path.join just concatenates two file names. And so I'm concatenating. This is basically the directory that my current file is in. And then I'm adding the word templates to this. If we were to run this in the Python terminal, it would look something like this. So here I'm in the Python terminal. I just want you to see what's going on here, because this is very simple. But if you've never done it before, it can be a little confusing. And you may as well just understand everything that's going on. So if I were to say os.path.join and run it with a string like home and a string like Steve, it just concatenates the two together. It gets the slashes right. You know, you could just say plus, but it just makes sure that everything adds up. So that's os.path.join. This other part, the os.path dirname, returns the directory of the current file. That's actually not going to work in the terminal because __ file doesn't exist. But it exists when you're running a program. So this just basically says, my template directory will be the current directory I'm in, /templates. Okay, next we instantiate what we're going to call the Jinja environment, Jinja Env. And basically this is a new Jinja environment, and we're going to use a file system loader using our template dir, which we just defined there. And this basically says when we render templates, Jinja is going to look for those templates in this directory, current directory /template. Nothing too complicated there, and you can just copy these lines. Next, I'm going to add a couple functions to my handler class here. I added two functions, renderStir and render. So the first function here is called renderStir, and this basically takes a file name and a bunch of extra parameters. This is the Python syntax for basically extra parameters. And we use that Jinja environment that we created earlier above, and we call getTemplate and give it a file name. This basically causes Jinja to load that file, create a Jinja template. We store it in T. And we call t.render, passing in the parameters that were passed into this function. This will be more clear when we actually use this as an example. And this just returns a string. And then I added this other render function, which I'll use all over the place, which again takes a template, a bunch of extra parameters. And it just calls renderStir, this other function, but it also wraps it in self.write, which is the one that actually sends it back to the browser. You'll actually see these three functions in most of the examples, most of the homework solutions and stuff I use in this class. I've just been copying them around. And in fact, what's funny is I actually just interviewed a guy at Hipmunk who had these three functions in his code. And I had asked him, I was like, where did you get those functions from? And he couldn't remember. And I was like, yeah, it's from this Udacity course I taught a little while ago. So anyway, yeah, these are handy little things. Feel free to copy them around. It's just for rendering basic templates. And next, what I'm going to do is move some of this HTML out of HTML and into a file. So let's create a new file and copy, and let's copy this code or this HTML into that file. Let's get rid of this %s for now. I'm going to save this file. I'm going to call it shoppinglist.html, and I'm going to store it in this templates directory that I just created. Okay, and now as you can see, since we're using this editor Sublime and it knows it's HTML, it actually started syntax highlighting things for us. And we can also clean up our indentation here without too much drama. So it looks a little bit better. You notice I still don't have any of the HTML scaffolding around this, you know, the head and the body and the actual HTML tag. That's because it's not really needed for this example, and we'll add it in later. It's generally good form to do so, but there's no reason to make you guys watch me type that over and over again.